On this channel, we talk a lot about free software, about software that respects the users, that does not exploit the users. And when you are a company or an individual or a group who is developing free software that is not exploiting the users, your chance to get a higher revenue is much lower than companies who do exploit their users and who really do all the dirty tricks in the book to extract as much money from their users as possible. So it is understandable that when these companies, even like the bigger ones like Canonical, but even community projects like Fedora, they have public testing, public beta testing, and we generally encourage the people who are using Ubuntu. So if you are an Ubuntu user, it's a good idea to participate in the Ubuntu testing week and submit all the bugs that you can find. So once the version is released, your bugs will be fixed, or the bugs that you encounter will be fixed, and it is a good idea. Well, you already missed the Ubuntu testing week, unfortunately, but Fedora 35 is just released their beta according to this this article. I couldn't really bother to find the official announcement, but in any case, the thing is, participating in a public beta like this is good because you can put your opinions or your bug reports, you can put them out in public, and these open source companies will handle your submissions in the open. So even if they don't want to fix it, you will see that they don't want to fix it. They might give a reason, they might not give a reason, but at least you will see that they reacted to whatever bugs you found, and you can decide whether you want to use the product with the bugs unfixed in the future or not. And, you know, of course, a lot of proprietary companies also do beta testing, but they usually do it in a very different way. But what is common here is that when you participate in this kind of beta testing, then you consent to use this software that is not ready and might, you know, do something unintended, might have some fatal issues with it, and, you know, you can do all your precautions, you can put it in a VM, you can put it on an old computer that you don't really use for anything anymore, or you can just take the risk on your main machine, but it's you who are taking a risk, and it's only you who it can bite in the butt, so to speak, if something goes wrong. But still, these companies definitely need, and especially the community projects need our help, so in general it is encouraged to participate in the open testing. If this is the only way you can contribute to free software and open source projects, this is what you should do. But when a company like Tesla starts beta testing and public beta testing of their so-called self-driving software, that's the point where I start to raise an eyebrow, somehow like this. Because, you know, if you are not following, there is this company called Tesla, which is producing electric vehicles, and it is led by this person called Elon Musk, and they've been selling, I don't know exactly what the name is, maybe full self-driving capability, I think is the name of the package they are selling for $10,000, I think, and they started selling it as a monthly subscription too. But the thing is that this is not really an autonomous vehicle software. So it's called full self-driving, and you would think it's fully a self-driving car, but in reality, it is a driver assistance system that requires the driver to always pay attention, and there is no liability on the company if something goes wrong in general, because you, as the driver of the car, in the driver's seat, everything is your responsibility to supervise the system and things like that. But in any case, I guess putting this out as a beta testing, public beta testing on the roads is one way they try to, you know, blur how this so-called full self-driving product is actually not a car that's fully driving itself. So they just call it a beta software and ask the people who already paid for the software one way or another, they ask them to test it for them. And this is not even the most shady thing about it. The most shady thing is that they are required to sign an NDA because You know, there are people who are very proud. There are many people who are really big fans of this guy called Elon Musk, and they are very big fans of this company called Tesla, and they are really proud. They put up their little cameras, and then they show how the car is driving itself, and they put it on YouTube, and of course the car does not drive itself well. In some cases it does some really dumb things, and people might, you know, cut out this short segment of your video of your self-driving Tesla and show other people, ha, look at this. This is how bad Tesla software is. You should do something about it, or, you know, Tesla is a fraud or things like that. And so what happened is that basically the FSD is full self-driving. So full self-driving beta testers sign a non-disclosure agreement in order to be a member of the early access program. So even if it's like a public beta testing where people are testing this software from the public, so like regular people, not like specially trained testers, it's just public members of the public testing them on public roads among other people, so in the public, I guess, they are still required to sign non-disclosure agreements. And well, what is it's this NDA says that do remember that there are a lot of people that want Tesla to fail. So don't let them mischaracterize your feedback and media posts. So if you have a very bad experience with this, please don't post it on the internet, because people who don't like Tesla as much as you do, maybe they would point out that this software is not really good. And it also encourages the members of the early access program to share on social media responsibly and selectively. Consider sharing fewer videos and only the ones that you think are interesting or worthy of being shared. So while on Ubuntu or on systemd, wherever, you can post your bug posts and it will be out in the public for everyone to see, and the reaction of the developers will be out there for everyone to see. In case of Tesla, for a software package that you paid for, you should only show when it works well. Don't show the public when it doesn't work well, even though you are testing it on public roads among the public. And this other article is basically talks about the same thing. Tesla really doesn't want you to see how its beta tests are going. And so this is one of my biggest gripe with this whole beta testing thing, is that when you download a beta software that is not production ready, that is not properly tested for every opportunity, and you download it on a computer that not just sits in the corner somewhere, but it's actually in your car and it can drive your car and take your car wherever it wants. It can accelerate your car into people if it suddenly decides to do so. It can suddenly drive into the oncoming lane and in the cross traffic where there are other people driving. So when you consent to test Ubuntu can screw up your computer, but you kind of agreed to try to take that risk. So whatever, it's between you and Ubuntu. But if you are testing a software that is driving your car and it drives into a crowd of people, or it drives into the upcoming lane and disturbing the traffic, whatever, all those other people who you are affecting with this so-called beta testing, they did not consent to any of that. They did not agree to have beta testing going down on their cities, which is infuriating and would be infuriating if they were doing it in my city. Unfortunately, or fortunately, I don't live in any of these cities where this is going on. If you do, I guess when you see a Tesla somewhere, just try to keep as far away from them as possible, because you never know if some just random person is just trying out how well this software is driving the car, and maybe it's not going to drive it well. So I guess, this is it. Beta testing is good when every participant knows the risks, and when you are beta testing safety critical stuff in like 100% real conditions without specialized supervision, I don't know how it's allowed, but I guess America is the land of the free, so you are free to endanger anyone on the streets if you can make some money with it, I guess. Yeah, I will never understand that. Anyways, see you in the next video. If you have anything to say, just, you know, comment and tell me why I'm wrong. And I will be back. Subscribe and like the video, as you should have been done already. Okay, bye bye.